Happy New Year 2024, another A-liner season. This year's New Year's resolution is to get this baby safe in any weather conditions.
Okay, I'm at Home Depot trying to find some poles for the sidewalls. I could do a video just on maneuvering your way through Home Depot. So I'm in the painting section. Here are the poles I'm looking for. Those are too long. And then these, it looks like, let's see what we got. A 4 by 8 foot, 27.8, that looks like it, right there. This is what John from my A-liner Facebook page recommends. So I've got that, now I just need to go find the little brackets to fit it in. Hopefully I don't spear anyone with this thing. This is what I need right here. Perfect. Plastic pole sockets. So this pole is $27 and these little brackets are $3. So not a bad fix for peace of mind.
Okay, so I got the paint pole home and here's the first dilemma I have. So here it is snapped into place. But it is too short to reach my A-wall. So I'm gonna have to get the drill out. I'm gonna drill some holes in it. I'm gonna try to drill some new holes in here to see if I can get it to fit just right. It's a 2010 Sport, so it's smaller than some of your 12-foot Rangers out there, I think. So I've just got it sitting there. It's not, the little pin is not in the hole. Oh, the little pin. It's not in the hole, it's just, but that's where I have to drill a hole. So I'm gonna have to mark that, go get my drill bit out and see if I can drill a hole in this pool.
And don't forget your PPE. So I found a 3/16 inch drill bit. It's about the size I need. So I've got my pilot started right there. I'm just gonna drill that out and we'll go see if that fits.
That worked out pretty good. Wow, that looked just like the other ones. Wonder if I should put a couple more in there just to be on the safe side. Well, I'll go check this one out and see.
I'm just gonna clean up some of these metal shavings. I don't wanna take those into the trailer. All right. All right, so here's the new hole I drilled. Let's see if it, pins. It pinned right in there. All right, that'll work. I'll go test it on the trailer. Cool. I love it when the plan comes together.
All right. That did it. That's a perfect fit. Now, I just need to put the little end caps in place so that they'll be permanently installed. So placement of these pole socket holders are going to be critical because you still have to be able to put the walls down without them interfering. So I have these where my braces are would work because obviously there's enough space there. Now it looks like I have a lot of options. So you can see with that wall down, anywhere along here would work for this cap. It wouldn't interfere with the cabinet anywhere. So now I'm gonna drop the B wall and see what kind of clearance I have on this side when it overlaps the A wall. So with both walls down, I got to make sure I have clearance on this, what I call the B wall, so that that little pole holder doesn't hit the glass on this side. Okay, so when I brought the B wall back up, I know that I have about, I know at least 8 inches on above the little bracket here that I can mount the pole holder. And then I just have to decide if I want it on the bed side or if I want it on the front of the trailer side. I love painter's tape. All right, so I took some painter's tape and I temporarily taped that about 1 foot from the peak. And then I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side just to test it before I permanently install it. All right, and that's about 1 foot from the top on the B wall.
Well, you know, it's always something. So here's the little whatever, pole holder. Here's a little pole holder. Guess what? It doesn't fit on the end of that. Holy cow. All right, so I'm gonna end up cutting the rubber off the end of that so it'll fit in there. Otherwise, I'm gonna have to drill a new hole because then it's too tight of a fit. All right, back to the drawing board. That's why I'm making these videos, so you don't have to do all this. So I just took my scissors and got it started. Now it's just ripping off. Hopefully it fits after I rip that off, because I don't think I can return this back to Home Depot now. And it fits. Beautiful. Phew, that was close. All right, let's try this again. Okay, so it fits on this side. That worked out good. And then if we follow it across, and this is a nice solid pole. This is gonna withstand a lot of wind. I don't think I'll have to worry about it. Much better than a shower curtain, because the little springs on a shower curtain is not gonna hold these walls up if I get into any real wind. Okay, so that works. That's a temporary hold up there just to make sure it works. And it's a perfect length for my sidewalls without stressing the sidewalls. You don't want to extend this pole far enough that it's going to stress your sidewalls. So, all right, now instead of drilling these into place, John from the A-Liner Facebook page says to rivet them into place, but I don't have any rivets. So I'm going to try double-sided tape as a temporary hold, see if that works. So I've got this heavy-duty 3M double-sided tape. And if that doesn't work, then I'll just have to go to town and get some rivets and rivet those into place. But before I do that, I'm going to make sure, I'm going to lower the sidewalls one more time, and just to make sure that these are going to be in a good location and not do any damage to the glass. Well, good thing I checked, because that's not going to work. That is sitting right on the glass. So apparently that is thicker than that thing. So I'm going to have to move it down or move it to the other side. Bummer. Okay, I just had to move it down a couple inches. So now it's about 14 inches from the peak. Here's the wall lowered. Let's see, it's not touching the glass. All right, it's double taped into place. I guess I'll just let it hang there for a few days and see if it holds up. But it seems like that'll work. It's a solid pole. It's not going to collapse. I mean, it'll take a lot. It would take a lot of wind to get that to collapse. And I still have my shower curtain I can put on the other side, although that's really not much of a help. So this is how tight it is against the wall. Not tight. When I take it out, I have to push on the wall just a little bit to get it to go back in. So you can see if I push on the wall a little bit, it'll slide right back in there. I think that's probably about the perfect tension you would want it. Any tighter than that would be pushing it. Any more loose, and it's probably just going to fall out. Okay, there you have it. Time's going to tell whether or not the sticky tape's going to hold. I'll probably end up having to use screws, but for now, I think that'll work. I'll keep you posted, and if you have any questions, add them to the comments. Otherwise, like and subscribe. It helps my channel. These ads get thrown on here, and if enough people subscribe, then maybe I'll start getting a little throwback from them. Somebody should benefit. Anyway, thanks for watching.